So, since we last spoke, Microsoft have actually added an iOS application to their Microsoft Lists app. Now, Apple have even recommended this in the UK as one of their new apps for organizing yourself. Now, let's explore more about this and how to get started. Before we begin, please do make sure you subscribe to this YouTube channel. It'd be great to have you here in the community. So, before we even think of getting Microsoft Lists, you actually need a Microsoft Work or School account to access this. Even if you had a basic account that didn't have these access, then you won't be able to get hold of Microsoft Lists. You also have to have SharePoint enabled because, as Microsoft have said, this is SharePoint Lists getting smarter. So actually, it's been a while since Microsoft have released SharePoint Lists in 2016, but as of 2020, this is its replacement. Microsoft Lists is basically spreadsheets, a little bit more advanced. A little bit how the likes of Airtable and Monday work. So you can do three main things inside of Microsoft Lists. You can track what matters. That's sort of their slogan. It's simple and it works on every device. It's smart, so you can use rules and quick editing, also some workflows and conditional formatting. And it's also flexible for business needs, so that includes different views. So to create a brand new Microsoft List, you create a new list either from an Excel or using one of the templates or a completely blank list. So it works very similar to any table. However, you can change the way that the views work, changing it even to a calendar view if you wanted to. You can express data in different ways in these tiles views, but you can also add conditional formatting and rules as well, which is demonstrated here. So you're probably wondering, how does it connect to Microsoft Teams? Now it's quite interesting, they talk about this sort of ecosystem of applications. They share how it connects to the likes of Planner and To-Do and how lists help you to organize workflow and track with formatting and rules. But yes, it can be embedded inside of Microsoft Teams really easily. So Microsoft have also released this new application on iOS, which is helping people to get started with taking these lists and being able to track them. But for everyday users, for example, school users, probably not suitable. However, if you're in the administration or the teacher side of stuff, it might be a little bit more useful for you. In the future, Microsoft Lists plan to add Kanban views and also week and day views. You can actually convert all your data into a calendar view at the moment, but that's stuck to a month view. So Microsoft want this to be your smart information tracking app. There's a great video by Bulb Digital, which goes really deep into this, and also by Kevin Stratvert that I think you should definitely watch. So folks, hopefully that gave you a decent overview of what Microsoft Lists is like. It's really very simple as a way to create lists and organize and track data that you may have added from Excel or through templates. Anyway guys, hopefully that was useful and I'll talk to you all very soon. Cheerio!